where we stand on the ships here.
Why would you ask that?
You're all shouting, and that doesn't help me. So, I'm going to assume, and I might be wrong, but I'm going to assume that everyone, most of everyone, a ton of you, are Docubus fans.
Yeah.
Great. Seems that they're coming. I feel like we should just bring Emily. Yeah. Everybody else.
That's
right. They're late, you know what I mean? Emily!
Lucky to come from, you don't want to oversell it, the greatest country in the entire world.
announcement. We'll talk about the weather.
But yeah, it was amazing, and it just felt like a certain group of people came together at the right time and were really supportive of it. And we cast so brilliantly, by 2-6 years old, that it all just seemed to come together in this magical land.
When you took over, though, you had to continue this message. And at any point did you go, you know what, I want to go this other direction, but we got to make sure we don't lose anything?
I definitely probably made different choices than Michelle would have made, but I was incredibly respectful of the vision that Michelle had put down, and she has a certain set of kind of like rules, which she would be loath to call them that I knew were important to continue. But also, we were lucky enough that we could see what was happening with certain characters and certain relationships, and it seemed really necessary.
What relationships? I guess.
But it seemed really important that because I took over in second season, that we knew there was documents was supposed to be meant to be. Yeah, they were important and felt like everything was looming that way. So
let's talk about documents. Zoe. Sorry, I'm just picturing the scene from the head. Sorry. Zoe, did you always feel like documents was the right way to go?
If I'm very honest, you know, no. I mean, here's what I mean by no.
Let us speak.
When I say no, what I mean is no. No, what I mean. What I think I love so much is that in the vein of not identifying characters on the show and not sort of referring to people as gay and bisexual and straight and not doing that, I also love the idea that there wasn't an agenda. Yes. And I think that speaks to that. I think that if there was an agenda, that it needed to be vulnerable, then we lose what we constantly keep talking about. So, and I was always open to whatever ending that it was. And had it have been Dyson and Bo or some other I think we're not, you know, this
read the room.
This is great. Yeah. But I think, like, you know, in the vein of things being just whatever they are in this world that we live in, that's full of different people, of different genders, of different ethnicities, of different religions, I loved the idea that it just could have landed wherever it might have landed without an agenda. It ended up with Bonemore, which was lovely to play, and obviously, I think for the audience, very fulfilling.
Yeah.
And I do appreciate and understand that as well. But yeah, no, I didn't have my own private agenda. No.
So much throughout the show, and we got to see her go from, dare I say, heartless to
dare you?
Dare
she dare.
Sorry. Heartless to a mother.
Yep.
What a huge transition. Had she not, spoiler alert. To the three people who were here. Had she not passed
you, who hasn't seen Lost Girl?
What are you still doing here?
Had she not
welcome you, welcome you.
Had she not passed her at childbirth, what would you have liked to see? Because she now is a kid, and the woman that she kind of wanted to be with chose some other woman. Where would you want her to be?
Yeah, I think it would have been really interesting to see Tamsin as a mother. I think it's interesting to see anyone go through the transition of, you know, being on their own to then having
learning to care for something that they have given birth to or adopted or whatever, just becoming a mom. And Tamsin is so honest in her emotion and her experience, and I just think that that would have been quite remarkable to be able to see. But I also didn't necessarily have an agenda for the end of Tamsin, although I had asked either for her to sort of just go out in flames, you know, true Tamsin style, or to find what she had ultimately been looking for, I think, on her whole journey, which was just love and acceptance and a peace. And I felt like the writers somehow managed to give me both, which was really, really neat for me. And so even though my dad, I was really happy with it. It was actually killing me because everyone was asking at DragonCon, I think, they're like, is there a Lost Girl movie? Like, would you be in the Lost Girl movie? And we'd already filmed it. And everyone's like, would you be in it?
We don't know where the Lost Girl movie would start from. It wouldn't necessarily start from where we left off.
It also could do flashbacks to scenes we never saw. So newly shot flashbacks.
I just want to say that Rachel's, I've been present for three live births of human beings in my life. Tamsin giving birth was the most traumatic thing ever. So I was like, she's actually having a baby. We should get a doctor. I can't do this. Yeah, that was the performance of the series for me. It was all real. The thing was so heavy. My back ached at the end of the day. I seriously had such a newfound respect for pregnant ladies. Except I was, though, I probably shouldn't say this, but I was smoking a cigarette on the corner. And people were like, so judgmental. I was like trying to explain that it was like fake baby.
Be the story. Like Tamsin and Lauren.
way.
Oh, hi. Who are you? I'm Smamson.
Or take it.
I feel like, given the audience, I would say more Tamsin and Lauren.
Yeah.